video, let's talk about the central chemoreceptors. And chemoreceptors in general are sensitive to blood and interstitial fluid chemistry, including oxygen levels, carbon dioxide levels, and free proton levels, or pH. And central chemoreceptors are found in the medulla of the brain, the ventral medulla of the brain, shown down here. And these are sensitive to free proton levels. But the free proton levels are acting as a mediator. They're sort of a middleman responding to increases in carbon dioxide. Now, that carbon dioxide can be derived from neuron metabolism, but it can also be derived from our entire body traveling within the bloodstream as our PCO2 of the blood. And during hypercapnia, an increase in blood PCO2, that CO2 will diffuse more readily and to a greater degree across the blood-brain barrier into the brain interstitium, as it is lipophilic. This will drive the carbonic acid equation to the right, generating an increased number of free protons, which will increase the stimulation of our chemoreceptors. Now, neurons are also supplying carbon dioxide and driving this reaction to the right, and those free protons can enter the cerebrospinal fluid from anywhere in the brain into the ventricular spaces. And so those ventricular spaces are filled with cerebrospinal fluid, which flows. And in this way, CSF free protons can access the chemoreceptors found in the medulla. It's important to note that the CSF has very few proteins in it, and therefore has very low buffering capacity. This makes it very sensitive to changes in free proton levels. In other words, they remain free proton levels. They are not buffered by bicarbonate or any other buffer. And so very small changes in pH are indicated by increased activity of the chemoreceptors, which will then generate an increase in output to these adjacent medullary brainstem regulatory centers for ventilation. We will increase the rate and depth of that ventilation, expelling greater amounts of carbon dioxide through ventilation. This, of course, would help us drive the carbonic acid equation either less to the right or even backwards to the left here, reducing acidity of the brain. And of course, it's essential that we do that, as acidification of our body tissues can lead to dramatic protein dysfunction, especially sensitive in the brain. So we want that hyperventilation to reduce our hypercapnia, to reduce our acidification, and therefore decrease the output of our chemoreceptors and return ventilation to normal.